find those wonderful flowers at?
Just up over there in the field, there's an entire field of them. Gorgeous.
Really?
Yes.
So, that rock too? Where'd you get that?
Oh, it's exactly like a moonshine rock. I found it on the trail.
Wow, that's very interesting.
Thank you.
One of a kind. Did it ever occur to you maybe to leave it for others to enjoy?
No, it hadn't.
Well, L&T principle number 4 clearly states, leave what you find. It's a principle about leaving the wonderful things that you find on the trail so other people can enjoy it as much as you do have. So, as far as leaving, you know, things for the rest of the outdoor people to enjoy as much as you have. Do you understand?
I do! I shall leave these flowers for all to enjoy! Thank you, M&T Man! Have
Thank
a
you.
Glorious life!
I'll never forget you, flower girl!
And I shall never forget you!
Now, on the leave what you find, in the Australian communities, they are very, not only do they strive highly to protect their environments, But not only that, but their cultures as well. For example, the Aboriginal artifacts are not to be disturbed in the backcountry or anywhere else. Yes.
Hey, why don't we just burn all that where it is?
No.
All right, guys. This is not a very L&T way of doing a campfire. L&T principle number 5. Minimizing campfire impact. This is clearly not a very good situation. You've got stuff all scattered around here. It's just gonna catch on fire and burn up the grass underneath it. It's just gonna be horribly damaging to the earth that's underneath it. And this tree here, you've got this huge live tree that's gonna catch on fire and possibly burn down. And it's just gonna be extremely damaging to this area, which is not a good idea. But if you guys will follow me this way, I will show you how it's really done.
Mixed up, you don't know what to do.
Alright guys, so this is my campfire. If you'll notice, all the logs and sticks in here are no bigger around than my wrist and no longer than my forearm, as per the L&T handbook. The reason for this is because the logs will for sure burn thoroughly through and completely. That way, when you scatter the ashes, there are no big chunks of coals, and it completely burns down, and it will biodegrade and go into the earth and rejuvenate and do all that good stuff it does. Like it's supposed to, naturally. No matter which fire building technique you employ of the many, you need to follow the following guidelines to ensure that your fire is safe and leaves as little as impact as possible. First off, never leave your campfire unattended. Don't try to burn foil-lined packets, leftover food, or other garbage that you would have to be removed, that will have to be removed later. Burn the wood completely to ash. Stop feeding the fire and give yourself a half or an hour or more to add all. Saturate the ash with water. Make sure it's cool to the touch and remove any trash. Rub ashes down to the fine powder. You can wear gloves to do this or place the ashes in a plastic bag to crush them. Scatter all the ashes widely with a small shovel or pot lid. And finally, restore the appearance of the fire site. With your campfire that you had earlier, I'm pretty sure it would have been impossible to restore the site to its original condition. What do you guys think?
Yep. Probably.
I hope you guys can take these principles and make minimum impact campfires from now on. What do you think?
I think we can do that, L&T Man.
Right on. Yeah.
All right.
Come on, man. You're making me step in the fire here. What's the deal?
Yeah.
you?
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, dude. I mean, cool. It's a little nuts. But...
Girl, you're on the knees. You can taste a bright light, but you won't be there for free. In the jungle, welcome to the jungle. Feel my smoking machine.
Now, that's what happens when you don't respect the wildlife. People can get hurt. It's dangerous out there. Never feed the wildlife. If you see something and it notices you, you're too close and you need to get away and leave the animals alone. If you respect them, they'll respect you. Be safe out there.
When it comes to the LNT principle of respecting wildlife, in some areas, it's not only the wildlife you're protecting, but the fawn life. In Ireland, fawns are so prominent that LNT has felt it necessary to incorporate protecting farm animals as part of the wildlife.